still believe it, 'cause I don't believe in myself. And I'm sick and tired of getting nowhere, 'cause it'll all work out. And I don't mind anymore. And I don't mind anymore.
Newton, you've just released your fifth studio album.
Yeah.
And it's your favorite album, I think. Yeah. How come?
I think the first album was obviously, it did really well, but I had no idea what I was doing when I made it. Like, I was really...
That's very honest.
Well, I was, what, 20?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was kind of good by mistake.
Mm-hmm.
And then I started trying to do things well in ways that I thought would work. And then I was kind of battling labels on like the third and fourth album, and it got complicated. And then this album, I felt like kind of everything aligned at the right time. I felt like I was in a good place kind of creatively. And I just changed label, and the label have been really good. They've worked it really well.
Now don't
I had the feeling that sometimes what I read about you, you tried to make the music, what would people like, what would work on radio, instead of just doing what you want to do.
Yeah, it's quite hard. I think everyone does that to a certain extent.
Mm.
And I think a lot of people lie about doing it.
Could be.
but I think, it's just finding a balance. Because mm-hmm. I think sometimes if you do exactly what you want, you'll end your career really quickly. It'll be really weird.
Could be true, yeah.
And sometimes if you kind of play the game, I mean, there's people that play the game and do spectacularly well. I think it took me a while to work out where I wanted to fit in. And I have carved a very strange space in the music industry where there's no one else in it. It's like I'm in my own weird little bracket.
That's great. Which is your own little niche.
Yeah. I mean, it's incredible.
To me that the tour's a bit different this time because you've got two people more on stage.
Yes, yeah.
So how is that turning out for you?
That's amazing. I think because we did one tour in the UK, which was the first time we'd kind of had more than just me, and I think we went a bit mad with stuff and noise. And it was just because, like, I mean, the tour before this was kind of what can we physically do? So we've done the what can we do tour. This was more what should we actually do and how much do we actually do. So this is much more of a show. It's got mm-hmm. a much better balance. And I think from people I've spoken to after the gigs, they're saying it's the best they've ever seen me. Oh.
ask you about that, because you're very adamant always about saying I don't do loops.
And I do now.
I know exactly. And I was wondering, was it difficult for you to take that step, because you were really adamant about it before?
Well, no, it's because everyone thought I was doing it all the time. So they thought Teardrop, for instance. I kind of went dun dun gap, dun dun gap loop, dun dun gap, and then play the guitar. But it's obviously all at the same time. It's a whole style of playing, and I think the person that stopped me looping, because I thought she just nailed it to such a high degree, was Katie Tunstall.
Waters my eye, most fitful mirror. Yes, on my brain. Teardrop on the fire, overcome phase.
And then obviously it's had a massive influx again now. And there was a period on like the kind of London acoustic circuit where I was the only person not looping for like 3
like
years.
Like an alien.
It was so annoying. It drove me mental.
I read that this girl in the audience actually didn't believe you, that you were not looping.
Oh yeah. No,
and I convinced her.
Well, I told her, just wait here, let me finish signing all the stuff, and then kind of went and got a guitar and played right in front of her and explained exactly what I was doing.
You're stumbling in the dark, stumbling in the
How do you prepare for touring? Because I read that you do some exercises to strengthen your back.
That was when I was playing stuff with both feet. It was really physically hard.
Mm-hmm.
So I was kind of doing quite a lot of yoga-y, stretchy stuff. And I mean, my favorite thing is still skipping.
I saw a video of you skipping.
I'll probably do that as soon as we've sound checked. That's my kind of exercise of choice.
Skipping.
These guys caught me doing press-ups earlier.
And it's hard to believe, but it feels like a step in the right direction. It's hard to believe, but it feels like a step in the right direction.
And yoga?
Bit of yoga.
It's quite probably nice to be flexible on stage.
Actually, drummer did, Toby Cooling, the drummer did, he found a Pilates class this morning and went and did that.
Nice.
Impressive.
I also saw on your Instagram account that you had a book from John Steinbeck, Eden.
East of Eden. I'm nearly finished it.
Do you read a lot on tour? Do you get the chance?
I read in the mornings. That's one. Read in the mornings and kind of late at night. But I love reading.
What's your favorite, or which book left a big impression? The last book that really impressed you?
Oh, there's loads. Most of which are written by Hermann Hesse. Actually, I've read pretty much everything Hermann Hesse has ever written. He's by far my favorite. My favourite author of all time, by miles. The only one I haven't done, I think I tried to do The Last Bead, came a bit too early. So I think I'm going to do that next. But I love everything he's ever read. Like Steppenwolf is beautiful, Gertrude's amazing, and Siddhartha's just, that completely, it's almost like causes like a chemical reaction in my brain every time I get to the end of it. It's incredible.
Oh.
gotta slow down. I'm hitting the ground, and I know it isn't right to scratch and fight another day. You are all that I want, but you know what I need. And I know it's probably time to find another melody. Come on, I got to get away. Save all of the pussy for another day. Could get me a ticket and an alibi. Nothing holding me down, teach me how to fly. Come on, I got to get away. Save all of the boozy for another day. Could get me a ticket and an alibi. Nothing holding me down, teach me how to fly. Here we go, up, up and away.
Well, I would like to do our infamous quick fire round with you. Okay, Batman or Superman?
Batman.
But I saw you with some Superman trousers.
Yeah, I've got pajamas of every superhero.
Have you?
I've got so many.
Really?
I think it's become like a kind of running gag at Christmas that my parents always get me some superhero. So I've got Superman, Batman, Spider-Man, all kinds of stuff.
Cool. Fish and chips or meat pie?
Fish and chips.
Tom Waits or Green Day?
Oh, that is like the ultimate.
I know, it's nasty.
That's like nostalgia overload. Oh, that's so hard.
Didn't say I was going to make it easy.
Oh, I might have to go Tom Waits, I think. Are they both amazing? But, oh, that's horrible.
But you said Tom Waits.
Can we make Tom Day?
We can make Tom Day. Green Waits.
Green Waits.
Okay, cool. I'm fine with that. BMX or skateboard?
Oh, BMX. That was my jam.
Yeah?
That was how I smashed my face up as a child.
Really?
Yeah, I fell really far.
I know.
Yeah, it was bad.
Anyway. You could fall quite hard with skateboards, as well, yeah, if you're on definitely. A half pipe.
I think, BMX accidents are worse somehow. There's stuff.
Yeah, because you have the bike. Yeah. True. Sunrise or sunset?
Oh, so I'm sunrise.
Yeah?
I'm a morning guy. Or
are you?
I stay up all night. One or the other.
Okay.
But I like getting up early.
I don't. Peter Gabriel or Phil Collins?
Oh, Gabriel. I'd go.
Peacock or flamingo?
Probably more of a peacock.
Yeah. Yoga or boxing?
Let's go boxing.
Boxing. Mountains or the beach?
Well, mountains.
Mountains?
Yeah, I'd go mountains a bit. I get a bit bored on beach. I don't know what to do with
myself. Yeah, I know what you mean.
Kind of sit there and I'm like, we do.
Yeah, true. There is water sports, of course.
It's true.
Okay, thank you very much.
Sorry.
It was a pleasure talking to you.
Yeah.
I'm really looking forward to your show with 3 people on stage.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a lot of people.
For me, it's a lot of people. For most people, it's normal.
And I hope you have great success for the rest of your tour.
Oh, thank you.
Audition.
Eins, zwei, drei, vier, fünf. Eins, drei, eins, zwei, drei, eins, zwei, drei, 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 eins. Fünf. Eins, zwei, fünf.
I think that's my favorite. Yeah, so that's